Let the valleys be raised and the mountains be laid low. Every meadow and field overturned. Make the pathway straight and the highway run smooth for the coming of God in our day. God, you come to your people as you promised of old. You have raised up the Savior in the sight of us all. Let the valleys be raised and the mountains made low. Every meadow and field overturned. Make the pathway straight and the highway run smooth for the coming of God in our day. You little child, go before him like the prophets of old, bringing news of his coming by the mercy of God. Let the valleys be raised and the mountains made low. Every meadow and field overturned. Make the pathway straight and the highway run smooth for the coming of God in our day. God, you come like the morning on the darkness of night. As a light to the people, like the breaking of day. Let the valleys be raised and the mountains made low. Every meadow and field overturned. Make the pathway straight and the highway run smooth for the coming of God in our day.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
With your spirit.
In this parish, a very important process is happening to a few of the members of our community. The process of the RCIA, Rite of Christian Initiation of Adults. Beginning this week, they will be accepted officially and ritualistically as entering members of our community, and they will begin to be dismissed from Mass. As they prepare to come into full communion with the Church, they will join us for the Liturgy of the Word, but because they are not ready yet to join us for the Liturgy of the Eucharist, they will be dismissed halfway through Mass to continue their process of learning, of yearning, and of searching. The Church joyfully welcomes today these catechumens. In the months to come, they will prepare for their initiation into the Christian faith by baptism, confirmation, and Eucharist. We also greet those candidates who, already one with us by baptism, now wish to complete their Christian initiation through confirmation and Eucharist and be received into full communion. For all of these, we give thanks and praise to God who has led them on various paths here to this place on this day. Dear catechumens and candidates, you are welcomed in the name of Christ.
The candidates for the catechumenate are Jeremy Stevens, Mary Troy, and Robin Walsh.
What do you ask of God's church? What does faith offer you? You're darn right it does. God is our creator, and in him all living things have their existence. He enlightens our minds so that we may come to know and worship him. He has sent his faithful witness, Jesus Christ, to announce to us that he has what he has seen and heard. Since you acknowledge with joy that Christ has come, now is the time to hear his word, so that you may possess eternal life by beginning in our company to know God and to love your neighbor. Are you ready, with the help of God, to live this life?
The candidates for full communion are John Fitzsimmons and Sarah Peary.
What do you ask of God's church? What does this period of formation offer to you? Those of you who seek to complete your Christian initiation, are you prepared to listen to the apostles' instruction, gather with us for prayer, and join us in love and service of neighbor? Now, this next question is to the sponsors in a primary way, but it is to the whole community in a secondary way. Sponsors, you now present these catechumens and candidates to us. Are you, and all of those who are here gathered with us, are you ready to help them on their journey of faith?
We are.
I now trace the sign of cross on your forehead, and I invite your sponsors to do the same. It is Christ himself who now strengthens you with the sign of his love. Learn to know and follow him. Let us pray. Almighty God, by the cross and resurrection of your Son, you have given life to your people. Your servants have received the sign of the cross. Make them living proof of its saving power, and help them to preserve in the footsteps of Christ. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Brothers and sisters, please stand. Let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison.
Let us pray. Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered at his right hand they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The days are coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and Judah. In those days, in that time, I will raise up for David a just shoot. He shall do what is right and just in the land. In those days, Judah shall be safe, and Jerusalem shall dwell secure. This is what they shall call her: the Lord, our justice. The word of the Lord.
O Lord, make known to me, teach me your paths, guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are God, my Savior, and for you I wait all the day. To you, good and upright is the Lord. Thus he shows sinners the way. He guides the humble to justice and teaches the humble his way. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul. All the paths of the Lord are kindness and constancy toward those who keep his covenant and his decrees. The friendship of the Lord is with those who fear him, and his covenant for their instruction. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, May the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, just as we have for you, so as to strengthen your hearts to be blameless in holiness before our God and Father, at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ with all his holy ones. Amen. Finally, brothers and sisters, we earnestly ask and exhort you in the Lord Jesus that, as you received from us how you should conduct yourselves to please God, and as you are conducting yourselves, you do so even more. For you know what instructions we gave you through the Lord Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Your salvation.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, "There will be signs in the sun, the moon, and the stars, and on the earth's nations will be in dismay, perplexed by the roaring of the sea and the waves. People will die of fright in anticipation of what is coming upon the world, for the powers of the heavens will be shaken. And then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. But when these signs begin to happen, stand erect and raise your heads, because your redemption is at hand. Beware that your hearts do not become drowsy from carousing and drunkenness and the anxieties of daily life, and that day catch you by surprise like a trap. For that day will assault everyone who lives on the face of the earth. Be vigilant at all times and pray that you have the strength to escape the tribulations that are imminent and to stand before the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We enter once again the season of Advent. Advent is a time, as you well know, it's a time of waiting. It's a time of watching. It's a time of seeds, of waiting to see the first sprouts. The church places the beginning of this season around the time of the beginning of winter, with good reason. Winter is also a time of waiting, of watching, of looking forward. To be able to look forward, we have to know where we are. To be able to cast our gaze there, we have to have the security that we know where we're standing. I'll give you three examples. I grew up watching football a lot. Last week, I watched football a lot. When the quarterback receives the ball, there's anywhere between 4 and 7 players gunning for him, coming the other direction. And the quarterback is trying to look downfield and see, while at the same time, everybody's collapsing in around him. And when they start to get really close, they bump into him. All of a sudden, his eyes return. And if he tries to throw the ball downfield, those passes are usually intercepted. When the offensive line holds, and he doesn't have to focus on where he's standing, he can look downfield. Here we go. When a child is learning to ride a bike, still coming to understand how the gears work, the pedals, the brakes, the wheels, the child will spend a lot of time on those first few goes, looking down. This is why it's so hard for the child to learn how to ride the bike in the first place. When you look down, goes every which way, and you're liable to crash into something. Those first few tries riding a bike don't usually last very long. Eventually, the child becomes confident in what's going on down here. All I have to do is push my legs. Then the confidence comes to look up, and all of a sudden, it's just like riding a bike. At the beginning of Advent, the readings are asking us to take a look at where we are, because we're about to start looking forward. The first reading talks about Jerusalem. Peace will come to Jerusalem. Jerusalem is a complicated place. Where they're located, talking about knowing the ground where you stand on, the city of Jerusalem, the kingdom of the Israelites, where they're located is not a great place to be in the world stage. During Jesus' time, it was the halfway point between global superpowers. If you remember back to your fifth grade anthropology or history textbook, there's the Fertile Crescent, the birthplace of civilization, they used to call it. And there's a wide green patch in what we now know as modern day northern Syria, Turkey, Iraq, southern Iran, down to touch the ocean. And there's a wide patch, Egypt, down the Nile River. But there's a very, very, very thin patch of green on that Fertile Crescent map that runs along the Jordan River Valley and the eastern edge of the Mediterranean. The thinnest strip of the crescent by far. This fertile land where crops can grow and people can live. This green, traversable land that's not desert. People back in those days couldn't even travel through the desert safely. This puts Jerusalem on the highway that everyone wants. The Assyrians and their brutal armies. The Egyptians and their penchant for enslaving other peoples to help them build the pyramids. The Babylonians, worse than the Assyrians. Later, the Persians, and still later, the Romans. Even though they're not from the Fertile Crescent, they understand the value of this land. This is what Jerusalem is pulled in between through the history of its existence, the Israelite people. This is why so many of the themes in the Old Testament are themes of the coming peace, the coming justice, the coming Savior, someone who will finally set Jerusalem and Israel on footing that will last. This is the same context in which Jesus comes into. This scripture passage that we have in the gospel today, Jesus' warnings, the warnings of the end times, this is in Luke chapter 21. That's where we are. And the very next chapter, the very first section, begins to talk about the plot to kill Jesus. Here at the beginning of Advent, the lectionary brings us right to the doorframe of the passion of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before we take a step backwards and begin to prepare ourselves for his coming at Christmas. The Jewish people at the time of Jesus were still waiting for deliverance and salvation. The same deliverance and salvation that the first reading talks about from 500 or so years prior. The people of Israel were waiting for a savior. Their exact situation was, the ground that they were standing on was, they were subjects to a much larger power, Rome. And it wasn't a very great place to be. They had no political autonomy. They were lucky to be able to practice their religion at all, even though even that was limited. The taxes were high, the tax collectors were corrupt, and Rome treated them very poorly, to say the least. This is the situation in which Christ comes the first time, into a real place, during a real time, according to a real plan. It's not coincidence that he chooses then and there to begin his work of salvation. It is in this time, and it is in our place, that the Lord Jesus Christ seeks to arrive again. The reason why we celebrate Christmas every year, even though it already happened, is to, in an intentional way, invite the arrival of our Lord Jesus Christ into our day, into our time, into our lives. And And to be able to look for him, to be able to look downfield, we have to ask ourselves at the beginning of Advent, what is the ground we're standing on like? Where are we? We have to know where we are to know where we're going. We have to be confident in our footing to be able to do the Advent exercise of looking ahead. That's what Advent's all about. So where are we? It's a strange and complicated world. It always has been. It seems more strange and more complicated now than it used to be. I'll give you that. At least it does to me. It's a world filled with distraction. It's a world filled with sin and evil. It's a world filled with competing powers and people. It's a world of anxiety. The Lord talks in today's gospel passage, do not let the fright, do not let the anxiety overtake you and cause you to perish. We live in a world of super fast communication. We live in a world of instant gratification. We live in a world of on demand. Gone are the days from 10 years ago of watching commercials. I watch a new show. It's not 60 minutes, it's 41 or 42 because I watch it on demand and there's no commercials. If I decide I'm finished watching that show, I switch to another one, the exact one that I want. I pick it from a menu instead of having to choose from what's on. It's a world where we can find anything we want at any time. It's a world where there's always more to choose from. It's a world where there's always something going on. I don't know about you, but I find the constant news cycle to be genuinely exhausting. Genuinely, spiritually exhausting. Because there's always something new. And most of the time, that something new, at least that which comes out on the news, is something bad. It's not the 24/7 newscast, it's the 24/7 bad newscast. Which dictator is doing bad things to his people? Which election in which country is being stolen? Which population is starving because their crops failed? Which country is having a brand new civil war after they just got done with one 2 months ago? Which town hall meeting ended in yelling and screaming? It's always that. It's a complicated world. It's a distracting world. And that is what it is. We can't necessarily change that that's the way the world is. There's very few things we can change. But we need to know that. We need to see that. We need to see those things coming so that we can avoid them and keep our eyes forward. We know what's there. We know the world. We live there. We know what it's like. Maybe we need to change what we consume so as to not always have to be checking where we're standing, so that we can keep our eyes forward. And this is not something that we do alone. It is the Lord for whom we look. But it's not as if we're on this side and he's over there. That's Pelagianism. That's a heresy. It is true that he is over there, and that we are looking. But not to spoil the story, but what happens at Christmas is that he goes from his place over there to also be over here, on our side, in our corner, giving us the strength and wisdom that we need to keep our eyes forward. So let us give thanks during this Mass for the Lord Jesus Christ, the long-awaited of the nations, who is there and who is here and who is here. Would our candidates and catechumens please come forward? And would the congregation please stand? Dearest candidates and catechumens, today we begin a new liturgical year. This is a time for us when we look for the Lord's arrival. He comes to us each day in a variety of disguises. Advent is a time to learn to recognize his comings into our lives. Wait patiently and prayerfully for his coming, for he will surely come. Go now in the peace of Christ to be nourished on the scriptures, to break open the word of God in your lives. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. To him all things were made. Salvation came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit.
gathered as God's family, let us lift our hands in prayer and raise our heads in hope to the Lord our justice, who is, who was, and who will come again.
For the church, that we may be attentive to God's presence and action in our lives, so that we may be ready to act when God invites, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this St. Joseph Parish community, that Christ may increase our love for one another and help us to be overflowing with generosity toward all who are in need, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all whose hopes are unfulfilled and whose dreams are dying, that God will inspire them with a new vision and a new opportunity to use their gifts to build up the human community, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace of vigilance, that we may take the word of God to heart and never be numbed into complacency nor trapped by worry, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For courage in facing suffering, that God will fill our hearts with courage and give us the strength to remain faithful even when tragedy and suffering enters our lives, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who fear the approach of death, that God will free their hearts and help them to look expectantly to Christ who brings life and salvation, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our servicemen and women and first responders in harm's way may be safe in these special days of the coming year, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the seriously ill in our community and among our family members and friends may be gifted with compassion and the healing touch of our God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sorrowing may be consoled by the hope of Easter promise, and all our beloved dead welcomed into God's eternal and loving embrace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, our God, we praise you for your Son, Jesus Christ. He is Emmanuel, the hope of peoples. He is the wisdom that teaches and guides us. He is the Savior of every nation. May the holiness of our words and our deeds show us to be watchful and alert for his great coming. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Soul at rest in him comes my salvation. For he only is my rock, my strength, and my salvation. My stronghold, my Savior, I shall not be afraid at all. My stronghold, my Savior, I shall not be moved. Only in God is found safety when my enemies pursue me. He only in God is found. Find lowly.
afraid at all, my stronghold, my Savior, I shall not be moved.
Only in God is my soul.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us. And may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. at the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Joseph our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Thank you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Miserere nobis.
Miserere nobis.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Miserere nobis.
Miserere nobis.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Thank you.
Dona nobis pacem.
Dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
There's a station for the low-gluten host on the aisle to the right, and for those that wish to receive communion on the tongue, there is a station on this aisle to the left.
Searched my heart, and you know when I sit and when I stand. Your hand is upon me, protecting me from death, keeping me from harm. Oh Lord, I know you are here. Standing always at my side, you guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting. Where can I run from your love? If I climb to the heavens, you are there. If I fly to the sunrise or sail beyond the sea, still I'd find you there. Standing always at my side, you guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting. You know my heart and its ways, you who formed me before I was born, in the secret of darkness before I saw the sun, in my mother's womb. Oh Lord, I know standing always at my side, you guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting. Marvelous to me are your works. How profound are your thoughts, my Lord. Even if I could count them, they number as the stars. You would still be
us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray. For even now, as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures. Through Christ our Lord.
Can you please be seated for a moment? This is the last week to purchase tickets for the St. Joseph Christmas Concert fundraiser. The concert is this Friday, December 3rd at 7 p.m. featuring Maestro Wilson Alvarez and various singers and musicians from our Wenatchee Valley. For those of you who are unable to attend in person, the event will be live streamed. For this event, you must provide proof of vaccination. You can purchase the live streaming online at numericapac.org or under Get Your Tickets. You can also purchase your tickets to attend at numericapac.org or at the parish webpage. Also, in the courtyard is the boat that will be included in the silent auction during the event. The giving tree is up in the narthex until December 12th. There are no tags to choose from this year. The items needed are gift cards for the homeless high school students and various items for the seniors at Garden Terrace. The lists of suggested items are in this weekend's bulletin, and we thank you for your generosity. Eucharistic adoration of the Blessed Sacrament will not be held next Friday evening, December 3rd, due to the Christmas concert, and will return December 10th. Also, in the narthex after the Mass this weekend, there are nativity stables and Advent items to purchase. The gift store will also be open after all weekend Masses until Christmas. Thank you.
Many members from our parish are participating in a Spanish language retreat this weekend, and please join me in praying for them, that their retreat may bear much fruit and that it may lead to evangelization here in the city of Wenatchee. Let's pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Slumber, arise from your sleep. A new day is dawning for all those who weep. The people in darkness have seen a great light. The Lord of our longing has conquered the night. Let us build a city of sod. May our tears be turned into dancing. For the Lord, our light and our love, has turned the night into day.
We are sons of the morning. We are daughters of day. The one who has loved us has brightened our way. The Lord of all kindness has called us to be a light for his people, to set their hearts free. Let us build the city of God. May our tears be turned into dancing. Let the Lord light in our love has turned the night into day. God is light. In him there is no darkness. Let us walk in his light, children of and all. Oh, comfort my people, make gentle your words. Proclaim to my city the day of her birth. Let us build the city of God. May our tears be turned into dancing, for the Lord, the light of our love, has turned the night into day.